I'm so happy you're here, and thank you for coming on the show. I'm very excited for you for this album. I think this is going to be a giant album for you.
Thank you.
March 18th. We've had you on the show a bunch of times. Mm-hmm. I think when your first mixtape you released, what was it? It was Heartbreaks and Earthquakes.
Whoa, knowledge.
And you, thank you. And you put that out for free on SoundCloud, going, yeah. Someone like me? Someone hear me?
Yeah, that's
someone, right?
Correct. Yeah,
and look at you now.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I know you have moments, but this is one of my favorite. We were talking. You once worked with Cardi B.
And... Well, yeah.
But does she know that?
No, she doesn't. Basically, what happened was we did a song together with Rita Ora and BB REXA, and it was one of those scenarios where we never actually met. When we made the song and we shot the music video separately and we were sending verses and whatever. And then she tweets the song and I'm like, oh my God, Cardi B tweeted my name, this is huge. And then I like check the tag and instead of Charlie XCX, it's Charlie STD. And then...
Close enough, not that far, are you? Okay,
Yeah, so
Charlie
then...
STD.
Correct.
So there is a human name that, maybe.
That there is an account called Charlie STD, which I think Cardi tagged it not once, but twice.
She thinks your name is Charlie STD.
She does.
That's fantastically funny to me.
Yeah. And, you know, I felt honored, actually. Yeah. I was like, if anyone is going to, like, make this kind of, like, online era, it's got to be Cardi because it's iconic. And I'm almost happy it happened. Yeah. And, you know, she can call me Charlie STD whenever she wants.
There you go, Cardi. She watches the show.
Yeah.
Charlie, that made me laugh. You have a podcast called Best Song Ever.
I do.
And I thought it would be kind of fun to maybe ask you quickly a couple of songs, just scenario songs. If you want, I'll play too.
Please.
Okay.
You have great taste.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. He does. He does. It's not a lie.
We're gonna
it's not a lie.
We'll add applause after the show in post. We'll add applause.
Guys.
All right, best song to listen to when you're going through a breakup.
Okay, I would say, like, get out of the emo phase, like, immediately, and go for, like, an iconic piece of art, like, I Got a Feeling by the Black Eyed Peas.
Really?
Yeah, just like get out there. Like, oh, no. I got a feeling.
Oh.
You know?
We're different.
You want to cry?
I got the Bangles Eternal Flame right now.
No, Jimmy!
All right, best first dance on your wedding night.
Okay, I have a controversial choice here because I feel like, I haven't been to a lot of weddings, but I've heard about a lot of weddings. And I feel like...
The funniest thing ever. I love that. Yeah.
I'm not being shady here, but I feel like All of Me by John Legend gets chosen a lot. And I think that's lovely, but I don't want that.
No.
If I ever get married.
No,
because I'm just like, oh, come on, like, let's like.
It's been done.
Heat it up. Let's like get everyone on the dance floor. So I want the Macarena.
Yeah,
yes.
That would be a great wedding song.
Yeah, because then you get that group memory with everyone,
Charlie,
you know?
I love you're funny. I love that.
Yeah, thank you.
What is... this is a good one. What is the single greatest song of all time? Wow.
Okay, tough. But for me, I have to go with Hit Me Baby One More Time by the Queen, Britney Spears. Yeah.
I know what it is. It's not that. I do love Britney, and I love that song. That is close. But I figured it out. I figured it out maybe a few months ago. The best song of all time is by you.
Yes, it is.
I was going to be no. I was going to, but it's The Promise by a band called When in Rome.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. Congrats on the album Crash. It comes out March 18th. Guys, pre-order Crash.
Oh, thanks.
Charlie XCX, everybody. Check her out on Saturday Night Live this weekend.